Check this out. This is an augmented reality sandbox, and this is one of the most fantastic things I've ever built for my classroom. This is sand. You can see me playing with it, and it's redrawing topographic shapes as I play. This isn't magic, people. This is science, but it's pretty magical. Here's what it's doing. As you change the shape of the sand, the program is redrawing new contours on top of the sand. Here's all it is. We've got a projector with an Xbox Kinect looking down at the sand. This is all being run by a computer program, more information at the end. And as you move it around, the Kinect sees the change in the sand and redraws new shapes. Now, specifically in this video, I'm going to show you how to build the sandbox. The technical information is coming at the end and where you can find all the help you need to run the program and to download the program. But for now, we're just using plywood. We're going to build essentially a box. I've got the technical information popping up there on the screen, and this is really the best size that the program is suited for. So the 30 by 40, I would stick with that if I was you. I've used a lot of 4x4-inch posts, both for the legs and for the stands that you're going to see, and I cut them at 24 inches. I didn't want it very tall because I wanted little guys, little kids, especially kindergartners in that age, to be able to play without having to stand on something. The rest of us, we just have to bend over to be able to play in the sand, but that's okay. This is going to get heavy. We're going to put 250 pounds of sand inside of this. So you can see I've really, really tried to build this very robust, including high quality, heavy duty casters. So it could be rolled around the school from room to room and especially taken to the elementary schools. You can see I've got braces between all the legs. Again, I want this 250 pounds of sand to be able to roll around, but I also want to be able to dismantle this, put it into the back of the pickup, move it to a new location, and quickly set it back up. So you can see I've tried to make this as portable as possible. Now for the projector setup, I've got what is a mount. The mount can be articulated several different ways, and the projector can be slid in and out of the mount. That was important for me because I wanted to be able to move this. Now, these are the screws that are pretty standard for projectors, but they took forever for me to find them, so I wanted to share that. And we're gonna mount the projector 40 inches above the sand. That's the recommended height. So now you can see I've put the bracket for the projector right on the vertical pole, and it's 40 inches above. My projector slides right into that mount. And again, this one here, I can articulate it on X and Y axis. And of course the Z by hand, I can really make sure I'm getting a good picture in my sandbox. Now for the Xbox Kinect, this took a little more ingenuity on my part because I wanted to be able to remove it. So I've just taken some pieces of wood there and built them up and glued them and screwed them in so that that thing can be taken in and out. You can see it's over on the side. I just built this box. This box is what's going to hold that Kinect up there on that projector stand. You'll see it in just a moment to really make sense of what I'm talking about. Now, I like to use some water on the sand. It helps you build a little more robust shapes and cliffs and nice plateaus. So we made sure to stain this thing really well to make it water resistant. And here's the setup process. You just put the vertical pole on with the hex bolts, slide the projector in, and then fill it up with sand. This is the good stuff. This is super white reflective play sand, and we're using 250 pounds. I wouldn't use any less than that. And here's how the Kinect goes in. Look, I've just fit that so it'll just squish down in there, and it's just held in by pressure so that I can easily pop it out. One thing you're not gonna hear about is that an Xbox Kinect does not have a normal USB. You have to get an adapter. So that's what was popping up there, and this is the finished product. When you're done, make some time to play. You're gonna want it. And if you wanna learn how to use this in a classroom or how to use this in another setting or all sorts of educational things and watch people doing amazing things, I've got another video. It's popping up on the screen again here. It's also down in the description and you'll see a link at the end. But check that one out. It's got all sorts of different uses for this amazing, amazing educational tool. Now, I didn't develop this. This was developed by the folks at UC Davis with a grant. They've done an amazing job and they've made everything available. The link is there. It's also in the description down at the bottom, and it's over at BealScience.com. Notice my high school kids, I can't even get them away from this thing. It's awesome. Come on over to BealScience.com and check it out. And don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching.